think it turned out very well. Thanks for your help, everyone.
It's not half bad if I do say so myself. Good work.
We should be thanking you guys. You're the ones who did the heavy lifting.
I still find it pretty hard to believe you were able to make a barrier over all of Michelin.
It's something that could only be accomplished through combining the witch's spells, our stigmas, and the Merkaba.
Not to mention the raw power of two divine knights.
And then we were able to convert the Pantagruel's orbital energy into mana to sustain the barrier.
Ha ha ha! Such beautiful teamwork! If we can do something like this, the sky's the limit!
We ain't exactly here for a team-building exercise, you know.
In any event, the barrier should hold. At least for tonight.
It'll be able to absorb a few hits from any railway cannon shots that come our way. Not that we'll need to worry much about them, given they'll be busy with the war for the time being.
I'm sure as far as the Chancellor is concerned, we're simply some minor rabble beneath his notice.
He probably sees us as nothing more than the opening act to the Great Twilight.
Opening act nothing. Doesn't he know we're the main event?
Hey there, everyone! Good to see you guys.
How are your rooms? Did you drop off all your things already?
Yeah. Honestly, I was blown away by how ritzy this place is.
I can't believe we have it all to ourselves.
Right? Even locals like us don't get many chances to stay here.
The last time was when Mariabelle invited us after the trade conference.
Oh man. That seems like it was 100 years ago.
Thinking back, it's kind of a bittersweet memory.
We still had a lot of fun, though!
Looking around, we've got quite the crowd here now.
Yeah, and a lot of us are from Thor's, too.
We might as well live it up, then. This is our last night before everything goes down, after all.
You're right. Tomorrow's when everything will be decided.
Our future rests on the success of Operation Shining Steel.
Though honestly, it's still a pretty dicey plan.
So, this is Operation Shining Steel, then?
After reviewing the whole plan like this, it seems more reckless than it does bold.
We may not have much margin for error, but I think this could actually work.
So basically, we're gonna get a bunch of teams to raid all the salt pails at once, put them out of commission, and then have the courageous two charge into the fortress while its barrier is down. That about sum it up?
Yes, but there's little chance that things will go so smoothly. I'm sure we'll have a number of unforeseen circumstances to deal with. Our top priority, however, is making sure the Divine Knights and Class 7 get to the target.
That's right. So even if something goes awry and the Courageous 2 is unable to land, we can continue with the plan. As long as Reen and the others can successfully board the fortress in time, we still have a chance.
Our foes will try to end the rivalry of the Seven as the Great Twilight reaches its climax. If we manage to seize control of the rivalries before then, however, we may be able to prevent them from achieving their goals.
At this point, they think they've already won. It's likely they'll welcome Instructor Reen since they need him to finish the rivalries. And that will be our chance.
That's all fine and good, but what about the salt pails? One glance and you could tell they're bad news. They're giving off one hell of an ominous vibe.
Yes. They seem to be pulsing with energy from the lower planes. And this same energy is what's letting them act as singularities, making them nearly impregnable.
Further, given the devils that have been appearing all over lately, I get the feeling we may find even worse things protecting each of the pales.
Yes, it's something we'll need to be prepared for.
Well, if we know what we gotta do, then all that's left is to go do it.
That's right. It's our turn now.
You can leave one of the salt pails to the Laboral team. We just gotta decide on which of us is going.
The same for us in the SSS. As members of the Radiant Wings,
Let us help clear a path for you and the others.
Estelle, Lloyd, everyone.
Aw, you guys.
Guess we should have seen this coming, huh?
You can count on us, too.
Duvali, are you sure?
Yes. Since my lord's passing, I've managed to clear my mind a bit.
The time has come for the Stahlritter to unite once more, to see our lord's will done.
Our lord saw fit to grant you her power. It's our duty to carry her torch to light your way.
All of you.
Don't forget to save some seats for us, huh? We'll be teaming up with those Stahlritter gals, if that's okay.
The Voss would have wanted as much from us.
Zeno, Leo.
Sheesh. This is one hell of a lineup.
In that case, you can add Sharon and me to the list of volunteers.
As maid of the Reintritt family, I would be honored if you would allow me to fulfill this particular role.
Angie! You too, Sharon?
Lady Angelica and I have also suffered at the hands of our foes. After careful discussion, we have decided it would only be appropriate to return the favor.
From what I hear, Lieutenant Colonel Mueller will be returning to the Courageous 2 tomorrow. I figured I'd leave the steering up to the expert, so I can get back to kicking some ass.
Sharon, Angelica.
Then you can count me in too!
Can't let you do that, Toa. We need you here. You've got both the Courageous 2 and the entire operation to look after.
Angelica's right. I'd very much prefer you to remain at your post.
I'll be on the bridge as well. But even then, I suspect we'll have our hands full manning the air defenses.
I... understood. There's no need for concern, Toa. We're all in this together. Every one of us has their own part to play. Thank you, both of you. But still, we can't just send them out by themselves.
And I guess you'll just have to let me join them.
Huh, so that's why you two were acting weird.
I'm sure you must think I have no right to come back like this. I can't possibly make up for everything I've done. But I'm going to help anyway. Because I'd rather not get the same failing marks Franz did.
George.
So that makes three. Not as many as I'd like, but...
Then allow me to lend you a hand.
Grandmother!
I fulfilled my duty as a witch, and Leanne has passed. Now that I have played my part, I may as well bloom one final time for you young folk. Were we to add my strength to that of the Ravner girl, a former gnome, and the Reinford maid, would that be sufficient?
That'd be more than enough. But if it's possible, I'd prefer to have the curvier version of you come with us.
Angie, I don't think now's really the time.
It would be our pleasure to have you accompany us, Lady Roselia.
For crying out loud.
We now have four groups. Our forces have expanded considerably.
But what about the last pale?
You can leave that one to me.
Principal Le Guin!
Aren't you supposed to be focusing on all that meal mirage stuff?
The plan has always been to leave the first day of the operation in Wallace's hands. I'll be taking over tomorrow, once the war begins.
Lieutenant General Bright anticipates that both sides will spend the first day scouting, with perhaps a few light skirmishes at best. Presumably, General Van Dyke will mobilize the Imperial Army with a similar mindset.
All bets are off once that second day hits, however. Odds are, all eight battlefronts will erupt into all-out carnage at about the same time.
The Imperial Army will likely be forced to a halt in both Liberal and Remiferia. You can expect they'll deploy their strongest armored divisions, the 3rd and 4th included, at that time.
Yeah, I thought that might be the case.
And the reason you're you're helping us out is so things don't get to that point, right?
Perhaps. It should be a suitable warm-up for the decisive battle to come, at least. Though, of course, I won't be going it alone. It's as the General says. We, too, will be assisting you. For the first day, anyway.
This will be my final duty as head of the Arsade School. I shall prove us worthy in succeeding the Sandlot name.
Don't know if I measure up to these three, but this is as good a chance as any to make up for all the time I lost.
Father! Tovol!
I had a feeling Vita would show up to help. Can't pass up a chance to hog the spotlight, huh, Vita?
Show them what you can do, Zero Artisan.
Thank you. We couldn't be more lucky to have the four of you with us. That goes for the rest of you, too. Estelle, Lloyd, Duvali, Angelica, Sharon, each and every one of you.
Indeed. And with that, I hereby declare Operation Shining Steel officially underway. We fly tomorrow at noon, as Mille Mirage and the World Serpent begin their clash.
We'll be rendezvousing with the rest of our allies in Michelin later today. This may be the last time we're all together, so we're planning to have a small celebration of sorts. We were hoping all of you could join us.
Sorry we're late.
Pardon us.
It's good to see you all again.
Let's get this game going. Not half bad. Thank you.
It'll be out shortly. This dish turned out superbly. Now then, bon appétit! Cooking, huh? I'll do my best. This is my signature dish.
Won't take a second. Yeah, this ain't edible.
Now then, shall we begin?
Thank you.
You win. I know when I'm beat.
Thank you.
You have my deepest gratitude. You have my deepest gratitude. Here's a little reward for your efforts. You have my deepest gratitude.
Thank you. Oh.
Sure do like this, huh, Reen? Tight lines out there!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Besides, until we manage to put this great Twilight business to an end, I'm living on borrowed time. Yep, any way you slice it, my being here contradicts reality itself. Doesn't matter what you, Adios, or anyone else has to say about it. My fate's not gonna change one bit.
Hey, how's it hanging? Let me take a peek at the goods. Whoa, not bad. Here's a little something for your troubles.